सो फर्स्ट थिंग फॉरमोस्ट एसओपी इज स्टेटमेंट ऑफ पर्पस. ठीक है, स्टेटमेंट ऑफ पर्पस ना किस कॉलेज में आता है? यस, अ लॉट ऑफ यू गाइस वर आस्किंग एनएमआई मिस डज हैव एन एसओपी बाय डिफॉल्ट. एफएमएस हैज एन एसओपी. आई एम बैंगलोर आस्क्स फॉर एन एसओपी. आई एम लखनऊ आस्क्स फॉर एन एसओपी. यू हैव माइका विच आस्क्स फॉर एन एसओपी एज वेल, राइट? सो ऑल ऑफ दीज थिंग्स आर going to be there. Okay, Anirban, yes, see, SOP requirement from a tier 1 or a tier 2 or Ivy League or a tier 5 college still remains the same. ठीक है guys, तुम सारे एक एक करके colleges के नाम मत पूछो. ऐसे बहुत सारे colleges हैं जो SOP पूछते हैं. ठीक है, and SOP can be added anytime for anybody, right? Why? Because अगर हमें पूरा प्रोसेस ऑनलाइन शिफ्ट करना है, सो आई माइट चेंज माई प्रोसेसेस, राइट? सो बी रेडी फॉर इट. व्हाट्स द हार्म इन क्रिएटिंग योर एसओपी एंड बीइंग रेडी फॉर इट, बिकॉज दैट्स गोइंग टू हेल्प यू इवन फर्दर अहेड इन योर इंटरव्यू क्वेश्चंस, राइट? सो आई वॉन्ट ऑल 500 ऑफ यू गाइज टू राइट एन एसओपी ऑफ योर्स एंड कीप रेडी इररिस्पेक्टिव ऑफ द फैक्ट तुम्हें आई एम बैंगलोर की कॉल आएगी या नहीं आएगी, एनएमआईएमएस की कॉल आएगी या नहीं आएगी. ठीक है, now you're going to do two things. One will be a 100 to 150 words SOP. That's like short, super short and concise. Okay, and second is going to be a lengthy SOP, which is 350 to 500 words. All right, now how are we going to write the SOPs, Ankit? Yes, it has to be college specific, which is what I'm going to teach you guys and move further ahead to understand how to write. Okay, take a screenshot of this. This is the most important slide. Okay, these are five things which you have to make sure you cover your SOP. All right, now SOP has to be college specific, absolutely correct. So what you're going to do is, out of my five elements, four elements is going to be same, right? One element will change. So I can keep updating my SOP basis that college. My main generic focus and structure stays the same, right? So now let's try and understand all the five elements which are most essential for your statement of purpose. Okay, first thing first, understand your statement of purpose. Whichever college is asking, the person who's going to take your interview is going to have a copy of that. And he will have a copy of that even before you come and sit there. All right. So your first impression is going to be this SOP of yours, right? So make sure it is the best and it is not left for the last day. For example, aaj aa gayi NM ki calls, kal deadline hai, to tum kal raat ko 11 baje khologe SOP likhna. Bilkul nahi chalega. ठीक है, सो कीप दैट इन माइंड. यस, एनएम आस्क्स फॉर अ 300 टू अ 350 वर्ड्स एसओपी. सम कॉलेजेस आस्क फॉर 100 टू 150. दैट्स व्हाई आई हैड टोल्ड यू ऑल कीप टू वर्जंस, वन 100 टू 150 वर्ड्स एंड वन इज गोइंग टू बी योर 300 टू 350 वर्ड्स. ओके, यू गाइस इन योर डैशबोर्ड हैव गॉट 86 सैंपल एसओपीज ऑफ एनएमआईएमएस. रेफर देम एंड यू कैन फोकस ऑन writing and making it better and enhancing them as well, right? Vishwa and all of you guys who are writing again and again, will you get PPTs? Yes guys, you will be getting the PDFs and the videos every Saturday for all the weekly lectures. It will not be possible to evaluate all 500 of your guys SOPs, but when we will be taking your mock interviews, we will review the SOP and ask questions respect to that. Okay, so all of you guys, please focus on your SOP and start writing. Great. Amber, I would appreciate, please don't make use of caps lock in the entire session. Yes, I know it's the first time you guys are preparing, so you all will have a lot of questions, but go with the flow. Understand you have a lot of things planned up for you guys ahead. It'll all be taken care of, but you need to make sure you are not skipping out sessions and being patient and being focused. ठीक है, सो दैट्स परफेक्टली फाइन. नाउ लेट्स अंडरस्टैंड what all is going to be a part of my SOP. Okay, first and foremost has to be a good introduction. Okay, now a lot of people have, you know, when you talk about your introduction, there are different ways of starting. Either you can start with some kind of a quote, which is pretty common. All right, it could be a generic quote which you read somewhere. But if you're starting with a quote like that, then you should, you know, give credits to whose quote it is. It's always good to know that. All right. And the best part is SOP, aapke paas pehle time hai, aap usko 10 review kar lo, 15 review kar lo, it's okay. It's not on the spot. So this has to be flawless, right? So if you're using some quotes, see how do you relate to it. It shouldn't be just I read ki kitna fancy hai, par mujhe iska matlab hi nahi samajhna hai. So then don't write it. All right. Anything and everything, every word which is written on your SOP, you should be able to explain, give an example, give a reason for that. All right. So keep that in mind. Very, very important. And when we look at quotes, either it should be a quote that you can relate or you can express yourself through that, or it should be a quote by somebody with whom you can refer. Okay, Ashutosh, it's not necessary. I'm giving you different ways to start your introduction. One of them is to use quotes. Okay, another way is you start with your life journey. Okay, you need not start an introduction which is there. Hi, I am Anisha Mukhija and I am this and that. Nobody told you to write an essay like a 2-year-old kid, write an essay on me. No, that's not SOP, right? So it should start with a little interesting story and a journey that someone wants to read the entire 350 words. Okay, so that's very important. Either if you can write something very well or original also, be it, definitely you can go ahead and write. Okay, so that's very important. Second aspect of it is, you know, your life journey. So ensure you cover up your entire background, right? You know, when I say background, it is not family background. Okay, aapka mom, dad, bhai, bhen kya karte hain is irrelevant to me. What matters to me is what is your background? Where, what have you studied? Where have you studied? Do you have work experience? If you have work experience, what kind of work have you done? What have you, you know, achieved there? So that's something which you have to keep in mind. It's your SOP, guys. Keep it in first person. Third person mein nahi likhna hai. It's not report writing. Okay, so give an introduction to your entire journey. What all should this journey include? Okay, this has to include all your major achievements. Okay, you can talk about your achievements either through your life journey or in the last point, which is going to be why should we select you. Okay, so you can include everything. You can include your social work, NGO, volunteering, anything if you have done, extracurricular activities in college, your co-curricular activities, you've got some position of responsibility in the college. All of these things can be incorporated, right? For people who have any work experience, you guys should mention about the kind of role which you are doing and what is the impact for it. Okay, Anirban, I would say avoid school level achievements unless you don't have anything else to talk about. It's the more recent your things which you are bragging about, the more relevant it becomes. Yes, internships, all of them are accepted. Okay, so that's something going to be very, very helpful. It's not necessary to grow in chronological order. Okay, it can be any order, but a flow, a sense makes it easy and better. So instead of going beating around the bush, if you go in a sequence of events which has happened, it helps. It makes it really interesting. Okay, you can use any online certification courses, online virtual internships, everything is open for it. Okay, you can do that. Okay, yes, all of these things which are mentioned out here should be covered in your SOP. No redundancy allowed. Yaar, tumhare paas ek hi mauka hai impression dene ka. Usme same cheez tum do baar kyun likhoge? Right? Nahi likhenge. No LOR coming here. No score rank of JEE, etc. coming here. As long as if you were in the top 100 or 200, you can write. Other than that, it doesn't help. Chalo, 500 agar JEE ki baat kar li, to utne tak likh sakte ho. Uske alawa mat likho. It's not going to be helping them. Right? सो यू कैन राइट दैट. हाँ तुम्हारे स्पोर्ट्स एंड एवरीथिंग कैन बी रिटन, एवरीथिंग कैन बी रिटन, ठीक है. सो दैट्स गुड. यमन आई वुड नॉट राइट अबाउट योर गेट रैंक. तुम्हें एमबीए करना है कि एमटेक करना है, राइट? तो फिर गेट का क्यों लिख रहे हो? रिकमेंडेशन लेटर यहाँ नहीं आएगा, ठीक है. स्कोरिंग 100 out of 100 इन बोर्ड्स नहीं आएगा. स्कूल लेवल अचीवमेंट्स नहीं चाहिए मुझे, ठीक है. सो कीप दैट इन माइंड. ऑलराइट, अब मैं 500 लोग के सारे क्वेश्चंस ऑफ सर्टिफिकेट ये सब नहीं आएगा. गाइस फुल फोकस अटेंशन. आई एम रिपीटिंग वन लास्ट टाइम ऑल द थिंग्स दैट कैन बी इनकॉर्पोरेटेड इन योर अचीवमेंट्स. ओके, वन, एनी अकेडमिक अचीवमेंट विद रिस्पेक्ट टू योर सर्टिफिकेशंस, योर यू नो एक्स्ट्रा करिकुलर्स, ऑल ऑफ दीज थिंग्स. देन यू टॉक अबाउट योर को करिकुलर्स और एक्स्ट्रा करिकुलर्स लाइक डूइंग एक्स्ट्रा सर्टिफिकेशंस, वॉलंटियरिंग वर्क, इंटर्नशिप, पोजिशंस ऑफ रिस्पॉन्सिबिलिटीज बाय हेडिंग फेस्ट्स, स्पोर्ट्स, विनिंग एट वेरियस कॉम्पिटिशंस, वेरियस लेवल्स एंड ऑल ऑफ दीज थिंग्स. ओके, हाँ, विदाउट प्रूफ यू कैन राइट दीज थिंग्स, ठीक है बेटा. स्पोर्ट्स बोला है तो नेशनल लेवल स्पोर्ट्स भी चलेगा, राइट? एनीथिंग विच इज नेशनल इंटरनेशनल लेवल विल वर्क फॉर ऑल ऑफ यू गाइस. ऑलराइट, सो मेंशन दैट. इफ इट्स नेशनल लेवल इन 10th स्टैंडर्ड यू कैन मेंशन दैट स्कूल लेवल अचीवमेंट, नो इश्यूज इन दैट. ओके, इट हैज टू बी ऑल अक्रॉस द स्पेक्ट्रम्स, शोकेस अ होलिस्टिक प्रोफाइल. ओके, सो कीप दैट इन माइंड, वेरी 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 इंपॉर्टेंट फॉर ऑल ऑफ यू गाइस. They will not ask for proof of everything. They will ask you proof for the certificates at the time of admission. Does not mean that you write everything which is fake. Okay? You cannot be fake. So please make sure you are not going overboard. All right? Then for WorkEx, guys, what work are you doing? What's your role? What's your contribution to the organization and impact? Very essential. Okay? Then we move to the next one, which is about is why MBA for you. Okay, now when I say why MBA for you, it means don't give me generic gyan MBA is going to be making me learn management. Related to your background. Okay, related to your background. Guys, I'm not going to repeat the same questions answers again. Please be focused listening. I have mentioned 5 times internships and certifications are allowed, right? So full focus out here, guys. It takes up time of 500 other students. So nothing else to be done. Your phone, your everything else should be shut when you're talking about your 10-11 GDPI sessions. Okay, great. Now, coming back, the third point is, give me an answer why MBA for you specific. That means you have to make sure you are relating it to your profile and your journey. Like, for example, now what I'm going, like, for example, when I spoke about my SOP, IT space. Now, when we are talking about IT space, I want to move to an MBA. Essentially, every IT engineer who's, or comms engineer who's working in Infy, TCS, Accenture, XYZ would agree to this is, you want to do an MBA because you want to get the hell out of there. Right, right. And I am at that kind of a perspective. Everybody knows that. Is it better? I won't want you repeating the same questions. Okay. Let's focus. I have 3 points to cover up. So I'll pick that up. Okay. First thing you are going to talk about is, in, yes, I'm repeating the last point, which is there. Include why MBA for you. Okay. When we say why MBA for you, all right, why MBA for you is going to focus specifically on relating it to your profile. Okay. So when I'm talking about my profile, so I'm an IT engineer who did engineering and worked with Infosys. Okay, the fact is I want to get the hell out of technical, which is there. So then we are going to make sure we are focusing on not writing that. Okay, you cannot go and tell I want to do an MBA because I want to get rid of IT. There cannot be anything negative in your SOP or your answers. Okay, So what you're going to do is you are going to do one thing. Okay. This is called as connecting your dots. So there are two ways of doing it. Okay. This is you. One option is you relate it to your past. Like, for example, I'm an IT engineer, and while I was doing engineering, I used to work with the marketing committee of my team in college festivals, where I got a lot of exposure to what is marketing and digital marketing and learned that. Then when I was working with Infosys, I did a couple of certification courses of digital marketing, social media marketing, did an additional internship while I was still working there, which got me curious and excited to study marketing. What did I do here? I related to my past. Now my past ka connect can be either it is the same stream of what you have studied or some kind of exposure you got working somewhere. That somewhere can be anything, working in your college, working in your best friend's company, your khud ka company, some company, anything. Okay? Second way is hamare past mein coach connection nahi hai par mujhe MBA karni hai, right? Then I relate it to my future. I have curiosity or interest. Okay, so then it becomes interest oriented, like what is my interest area. Okay, so you can do that. Of course, Anant, you can do both of them. It's definitely good, right? So you have to make sure you are connecting that. All right. Yash, present. So obviously, if you are working on to it, you can talk about it, right? So if your MBA, your logical extension itself is MBA, then go ahead. You can talk about your current role, your current studies, academics, which you are doing, all of these things. Yes, you can talk about family business and all of these things. How to justify future, which is there. Very interesting. Now, how do you justify with respect to your future is you can say I am reading a lot of books on the same, or I have started preparing for certification courses of it, which is going to be helpful, right? So you can talk about your interest. That is why you want to study that. Okay, so you have to make sure you are connecting to all of these things. Okay, Akshay, tumhare paas mein BCom se you can do an MBA, no problem in that. You have to find connect with your subjects or find connect with something which you have done. Okay, moving on to the next part, which is the most essential part, is include why the college. So if you know ki ha mujhe I am Bangalore ka call for sure aane wala hai, mujhe I am Lucknow ka call for sure aane wala hai, NMIMS ka call aane wala hai, you should have one paragraph about these colleges already ready for you. Okay, here we are not going to say I want to do this XYZ college because I like the building or I like the placement or the ranking. Don't give me generic gyan. You are going to talk about why it is important for you. No, not to talk about ROI. Do not talk about placements and sensitive topics. Don't give them the impression that I'm coming for an MBA to get money. We can't say that. Okay? So focus on talking about important things about the college. Okay? You have to do your thorough study for it. Okay? MBA is by default a place for networking, getting exposure, and all of these things. You are not going to mention that. ठीक है? NMIMS में जाना है, I am Bangalore में जाना है, तो जाओ उनकी वेबसाइट पे चेक करो. What are they bragging about? Right? What are, you know, those things like, for example, probably you've read about some faculties. I would like to be a part of this faculty, or I would love to be a part of some club or committee which is there, some kind of initiatives which the college has taken which encourages you to come out there and be a part of the same thing. And this is what you have to talk. It should come and across as you have done your study, you have done your research of reading about the college, and then again you relate it to your goals. That is why it becomes why that college for you. Okay, yes, you can talk about the college alumni, the curriculum, you can talk about it. Brand I am Madhur is going to be of no use. उनको पता है आई एम ब्रांड है, उनको वो चीजें नहीं बताओ विच इज यू नो लाइक ऑब्वियस. ओके देवेश, सेम क्वेश्चन, यू आर राइटिंग मल्टीपल टाइम्स, हाउ टू टॉक अबाउट स्टार्टेड एन ई कॉमर्स बिकॉज इट स्टॉप डूइंग. इट्स ओके, यू स्टार्टेड समथिंग, यू फेल्ड, टॉक अबाउट वॉट यू लर्न फ्रॉम इट. ठीक है, सो यू गाइज कैन टॉक अबाउट दैट, इट्स ओके. ऑल राइट, नो नीड टू मैंशन टॉप बी स्कूल एलुमनाई, यू कैन टॉक अबाउट एलुमनाई. Top B school ranking, placements, placement numbers, to be a network does not come. Does not come. You will not write these things. ठीक है? So focus on things which would make the person who's reading, अरे वाह इसने मेरे college के बारे में इतना पढ़ा है, इतना research करा है. ठीक है? So that's going to be helpful. यार if you have time, कर लो certifications, not a waste at all. कहीं ना कहीं तो काम में आ ही जाएंगी, इट विल नॉट गो इन वेस्ट. ठीक है, सो कीप दैट इन माइंड. शैलेश, आई डोंट अंडरस्टैंड योर क्वेश्चन फॉर कैप राउंड क्वेश्चन मार्क, आप कब से फॉर कैप राउंड पूछ रहे हो? ठीक है, मेक अ कंप्लीट क्वेश्चन, इट विल बी हेल्पफुल. नाउ इफ यू गाइज नो विच स्पेशलाइजेशन यू आर इंटरेस्टेड, डू मेंशन इन योर एसओपी. ओके, डू मेंशन इन योर एसओपी. रेफरेंसेज, इफ पीपल यू आर then go ahead, you have to give references of people you have worked with or good faculties who will give a good review about you. All right, so that's important. Abhishek, Six Sigma and marketing director nahi hai, but something is better than nothing, to mention kar sakte ho to learn extra. I did that course. Yes, Rahul sir, recommended, engage. Yaar time hai to kar lo. We teach a lot of interesting things, like I teach brand marketing. You'll have a couple of the others teaching you blockchain, analytics, all of these things. ठीक है, तो वो कर सकते हो to enhance your profile. All right, great. Now, very nice question, Ritvik. I think this is an important question a lot of people get. तुम्हारा profile is fully finance based. CA हो तुम, ठीक है, but तुम्हें MBA marketing में करनी है. It's okay to mention in SOP and interview, I want to do an MBA in finance. Once you go inside the college, nobody cares which stream you took. ठीक है? So nobody cares. Similar lines for people who are like engineers who are struggling. How do I justify engineering ke baad finance? Mat karo. Tell them I want to do an MBA in technical engineer, IT, that's doing so well. At the end of it, once you get inside the college, nobody cares what had you mentioned, right? So you can absolutely get on board, get inside the college. Uske baad jo choose karna hai karo. Everything is possible. And mechanical engineers also can do. Guys, 80% of the college is going to be engineers. Theek hai, so don't worry about that. SOP and interview mein, you have to convince me to take you up. Okay, the only college where your specialization matters before is going to be SP Gen, because your form itself and your shortlist itself is going to come stream specific. Tumhe call hai marketing ki to tum wahan jaake nahi bol sakte mujhe finance karna hai. Mari operations ki call hai to tumhe operations hi bolna padega. Theek hai, so keep that in. Shubham, 4 years ka gap to beta justify karne ke liye bahut acche se socho, kuch courses karo, kuch cheeze karo which you can cover up. Theek hai, अटेम्प्ट टू स्टार्टअप कर सकते हो मेंशन, बट टेल मी व्हाई यू वांट टू टॉक अबाउट समथिंग व्हिच यू फेल्ड एट. इट्स द फर्स्ट इंप्रेशन. यू वांट टू टॉक अबाउट योर फेल्ड स्टार्टअप, टॉक अबाउट इट इन सम इंटरव्यू क्वेश्चन, राइट? व्हाई डू यू वांट टू स्पीक अबाउट दैट, यू नो, व्हिच यू आर फोकसिंग ऑन इन टर्म्स ऑफ समथिंग वेयर यू फेल्ड, राइट? CA ड्रॉप कर दिया, क्यों बताना है उसको? पूछा उसने आपको फेलियर? नहीं पूछा, राइट? सो व्हेन यू आर टॉकिंग अबाउट द एसओपी, ओनली गुड एंड पॉजिटिव थिंग्स. यू नीड टू मेक मी सिलेक्टिव, नॉट रिजेक्टिव. ठीक है, सो नो कैप, नो नेगेटिव पॉइंट्स. दिव्या, अनफॉर्चुनेटली यू आर आस्किंग मी क्वेश्चंस व्हिच यू नो नोबडी कैन जस्टिफाई. गाइस, सिलेक्शन पैरामीटर अगर किसी कॉलेज का है, आप उसको चेंज नहीं कर सकते. टेंथ का वेटेज उसने ज्यादा क्यों दिया है, उसने वर्क एक्स को वेटेज कम क्यों दिया है या ज्यादा क्यों दिया है, आप कुछ नहीं कर सकते हो. फोकस ऑन थिंग्स विच आर इन योर हैंड, थिंग्स विच आर नॉट इन योर हैंड फॉरगेट देम. यू कैन यूज योर गोल्स व्हेन यू आर टॉकिंग अबाउट एमबीए, दैट रिलेट्स टू योर गोल्स. ठीक है, लास्ट थिंग इज एंड ऑन अ नाइस नोट, व्हाई शुड दे सिलेक्ट यू. सो हियर इट गिव्स मी अगेन हेड रूम टू टॉक अबाउट माई अचीवमेंट्स एंड वॉट विल यू बी गेटिंग एज अ वैल्यू एड टू देयर कॉलेज. Okay, so mention those things and this makes your entire SOP complete. Deep, you have an idea about a long-term company, entrepreneur banna hai, aap likh sakte ho, but give a brief idea of it then. Shubham, you can mention your M.Tech, it's okay. Academic diversity ka advantage beta sab college mein milega aapko. सब कॉलेज में, बट यू हैव टू मेक श्योर यू आर स्ट्रीट स्मार्ट इनफ टू प्रूव मी आई शुड टेक यू. ठीक है, अंडर ग्रेजुएट स्ट्रीम इज इट नेसेसरी? इट्स नॉट नेसेसरी, नथिंग इज मैंडेटरी, यू डोंट नीड टू मेंशन कॉलेज नेम ऑल्सो. क्या फर्क पड़ता है, अगर आप हो अच्छे कॉलेज से, IIT से हो, NIT से हो, यू वॉन्ट टू ब्रैग अबाउट इट, गो हैड ब्रैग अबाउट इट, बट इफ इट इज नॉट अ मेजर अट्रैक्शन फैक्टर, यू कैन स्किप इट, नो वरीज इन दैट. ओके, so which is very very important. How do engineers justify they want to do an MBA in finance? Anubhav, I told that a couple of minutes back. You talk about things you have done with relevance to management in your college, why management excites you. So either you connect to your past or you connect to something which is your keen interest, and tell me why it is your keen interest. Nayan, how to check grammar mistakes in SOP? beta, word mein grammar check ho jata hai, grammarly ki app mein check karo, कहीं ना कहीं तो चेक करो, बट ग्रामर मिस्टेक्स एंड स्पेलिंग मिस्टेक्स आर एब्सोल्युटली अ बिग नो नो. यू हैव हेल लॉट ऑफ टाइम टू राइट योर SOP, प्लीज अंडरस्टैंड वी कैनॉट अफोर्ड दैट. सी, इफ यू डू नॉट हैव एनी अदर कोर्सेज, तो कोर्सेरा, यूडेमी सबके सर्टिफिकेशन कोर्सेज वैलिड है, नॉट एन इश्यू एट ऑल. ठीक है, वाई सिलेक्ट यू, यू आर गोइंग टू बी टॉकिंग अबाउट योर एस्पेक्ट्स ऑफ वॉट अचीवमेंट्स विच यू वॉन्ट टू हाईलाइट. ठीक है, so keep that in mind. Now moving further ahead, you guys are repeating the same questions. I'm not repeating what to select you. Check out the recording once again. Okay, so now we talk about, Ankita, I'm not referring to interview questions. Our objective for today is only about SOP. All right, SOP relevant questions will be taken up. Great. Now moving further ahead, what all things you need to keep in mind? Why are the people asking you for an SOP firstly? Right, the objective is they want to know you, get an idea about you before they meet you, right? So that is why it is a reflection of all your best qualities. You have to put an emphasis on your achievements, which will be something which is important, and it kind of brings about things about you. Okay, now some of you guys, some of the people actually, right, like Kiran is asking me hobbies in SOP. What will be your hobby? What, I like to dance. If you have done a classical level dance certification, then talk about it. Otherwise, don't. I do not want to know your interests and hobbies, your strengths and your weaknesses. Nahi zarurat hai. SOP is your first impression to impress me. Always, always think about thinking like a manager. Theek hai? Mohammed Faraz, animation, interesting hobby, but do I want someone who can be a manager, who can animate? No, right? So don't write all of these things. Okay? So keep that hobby tumhari kuch bhi ho, SOP mein nahi aayegi. Nahi aayegi. Theek hai?